lower end radius, where it's a novel method.
Good morning to everybody, respected chairman sir. Majority of these fractures, although initially reducible by manipulation, may be inherently unstable and will collapse with a simple cast and immobilization. AOS recommendation, clinical treatment guidelines recommend weekly radiograph for the first 3 weeks. Therefore, majority of the patient by close method, they will go for malunion. In practical observation, the majority of this patient, though they are malunited functionally, in our population they feel well. So there is no problems, no functional improvement. There is some improvement, but they are carrying on. Evidence-based review of distal radius fracture, although the popularity of hollow locking plate fixation continue to grow, there are limited high-powered quality studies to prove its superiority over the other methods. This is 2018 study March. So, and complications rate of locking plates in the comminuted lower end radius fracture 16 to 25%, and with adequate knowledge and implants variations in our population, probably the implant failure rate must be more than that. So a new concept in the treatment of lower end radius fracture with the anterograde intramedial nailing. To tell you very frankly, I am not against of plating or external fixate or lower end radius pinning, but this is just my thought and view. My indications for anterograde nailing, pinning, surgically compromised environment, compromised local condition of the patient, poor socioeconomic condition, inadequate surgical expertise as I have. Philosophy of the fixation is to support the subchondral bone of the distal fragment by anterograde intramedullary lambrinoidi or K-wire till fracture union. Method is after routine sterilization, close reduction, and then temporary K-wire fixation till you finish the procedure. Forms wrist joints 6 to 7 cm, a small incision is given below the insertion of the pronator teres, and you just retract the tendon of abductor pollicis longus and develop interval, and then with this you pass a drill, 2.5 mm drill bit in large size bone, provided that diameter of the drill hole is less than the half of the width of that particular level of radius. Then pass guide wire, this lambrinoidi wires, on both the direction. One is on radial side and other is on ulnar side, and then third wire you pass anywhere it goes. But most important, there are two wires, first on the lateral side and then on the medial side by pre-bending. So now this is how it is. Suppose if you are not able to reduce the inferior radial ulnar joint, then you fix the radial ulnar joint after reduction first and then do the job. Now the three wires will go from one medial, one lateral, and probably one will be in the center or somewhere else. So this is the method. Summary of a comminuted distal radius fracture with intra-articular extension with displacement, I have done it. But I don't propagate by enlarge for this method. It is for the metaphyseal colisis displaced fracture mostly. And if at all you want to do it with intra-articular multiple pieces are there, X-fix support is required for at least a month. So this is how it is, the method, elevation of the fragment, reduction, and then fixation with the 3K wires. Any matter of the inferior radial ulnar joint is not reduced, you can pass a temporary K-wire ulnoradial for 3 weeks. Now this is the closure of blunt tip ends. Cut it to the flushing with the bones, proximal and K wires bent and buried in the subcutaneous tissue. And whenever you close the wound, you must see that it is in the center. Three patient, diazodine, external fixation, acceptable reductions and radiological criteria, 3 weeks to 4 weeks immobilization. And these are all cases, a 45 years old, fixed with the two-wire, functional, excellent intra-articular restoration. Another diapons complex fracture fixed with these three pliers and perfect anatomical restoration. And you can see even the these fossas are also restored. Another case, this is how we can see after removal of the pins, there is some dorsal teeth, but that is acceptable. This is after osteopath, multiple comminuted, you cannot do a plating in this case, and the things were done by multiple K-wire osteoporotic bone, many more than three wires also, and ultimately this has a good function. So I can quote you innumerable examples, and probably I have done more than now 32 patients with a good anatomical reductions and fixation and full range of movements. Another example, multiple pieces, comminuted piece, swollen, not fit for plating, I have done it. And even in a diapons fracture, indirect elevation and stabilization by the pins, perfect anatomical restoration of the lower end radius. After 4 months, you can see the patient starts mobilization and everything. So 32 patients, I don't say that they are all excellent. Probably 12 patients were rated clinically excellent, 18 were good, and they are acceptable to us, but none is poor. So overall high consensus was found for non-operative treatment instead of operative treatment in a dislocated extra and intra-articular distal radius fracture with an acceptable close reduction regardless of the age. It is a 2017 European Journal. And it is that there is a no clinical evidence and conclusion over the 65 years of age that 2 mm articular step matters very much, and plate may not give a adequate superior results. So take home message, choice of treatment, transparency to limitation of available data with me, treatment ultimately relying on the surgeon's experience and preference. I am not against anybody who is doing plating, nailing or anti-grade wiring. Thank you very much.